luggage, yeah. too. Yeah. yeah, no, but it was just, you know.
Yeah, I did Delta with my lab, and he was an adult dog, but yeah. he was freaking out.
Oh, yeah.
And to hear him yelping and crying,
yeah, it was
and
upsetting.
I wouldn't,
See,
I didn't want to give him a sedative or anything like that.
I know a lot of people who ship dogs, because the dog's used to being in a crate by itself. Because, you know, we go to a lot of trials and stuff, and we stack the dog's crates in the crating area, and we leave, and we're doing stuff, we come back, and so they're pretty comfortable in a crate,
yeah.
and surrounded by strangers, so yeah. I don't think, and you know, they're in a pressurized part of the plane and all. I actually don't think my dogs would be that upset by the experience.
Yeah.
But I'd be just worried.
Yeah.
It was
really stressful.
And if I mean, I suppose there's a chance at some point I might fly with him, but it would only be a direct flight. I would never let him be transferred.
No, yeah. No way.
I don't think I'll ever do it again, even if
that was the case, because it was just so traumatizing.
Well, the number of people who want to ship puppies, there's nothing wrong with it. And I'm just like, that's one of my, like this girl from California. I'm like, well, you know, I don't ship. And she's like, well, no, I wouldn't want to ship. You know, okay, well, we can talk then. You know, but that's just, you know, and it actually is one of my concerns with her is her family's out here. So I suspect she'll be flying back and forth a lot. And, you know, we've talked about airlines and all.
Yeah.